The Bethany Purim Spiel Greatest Hits.
Because you could not exist. What am I, chopped liver? If this were 2020, you'd be old chopped liver, that old chopped liver. It just keeps molding along. I should have filled the Homintosh with chopped liver. It's more powerful than poppy seed or plutonium. The unnatural juxtaposition of two holidays failed to create an adequate wormhole through time and space. Now where am I? And when am I?
This is an alternate dimension. And I should be a clue.
Am I going to meet with foul play?
Look, I'm from a farm. Like, I'm farmish. Don't I look farmish?
Am I going to be cooped up?
Don't be a silly cluck. Don't cluck. This is a farmish dimension. And all the Bethany spiels that we've done in the past still exist here. In this farmish dimension, we can put them back together again and still defeat Haman. So stop walking.
I'm not miserable. I'm in Les Miserables.
Drink the Haim, two spiels gone by. This one makes number 15. We did Beatles once, then we did it twice.
Hey, last year Back to the Future was nice, and we sang both songs between.
British Beatles, we read Colette O'Connor of song. In our love spiel we stay on local terms. Robert was what you expect. Drink the heart, you come.
Live
in Abba-Ward, Elbach. Had to be a good guy, and so that is what I play.
To the barricades, storm the Bastille, let the attack begin. Be brave, be chicken-hearted.
May we
search amongst.
At the start of the spiel, everybody has spiel pets. And the spiel is like there are ants in your pants. I have sheriff.
Do what I say.
We watched it.
I won't obey.
Good morning,
I need the job.
Bad Haven.
Later.
What would it feel? What's it about? What it feel? Once again, we are just feeling.
At the start of the spiel, there's a French Revolution. Just a story of Esperance, we like the scroll. And the scene is Shushantown, where the Hebrews are happily living, and Haman is hanging around, taking control.
For that. That's Golden Palace Gate Park, circa 1968.
Whoa! Did we miss it? Are we too late?
You're never too late for my party. On my mind, oh my. I'm in no hurry, I can take my time, oh my. After 180
days,
I can still dance in those gyrate ways.
He's got moves, so he's style, oh my.
Let's spend 6 months together, plus 1 week for good measure. Let's spend 6 months together now.
Ba-da-ba-da-ba-ba.
Oh my mind.
Ba-da-ba-da-ba-ba-da-da.
Let's spend 6 months together. Comes down, dance around, and wears her clothes. Get a simple wife together to come make this party better. Let's simple wife together.
Let's simple wife together. Come make this party better. Don't send the eunuch king in without you, without.
You summoned me?
Of course I summoned you, Queen Vashti. If you had come unsummoned, I'd have to put you to death. Unless, of course, I raised my golden scepter. And I just don't seem to remember where I put it.
Well, King Ahasuerus, I'm here. But I am not going to dance for you. However, you may listen to me sing. Hit it. What you want, King, yeah, I got it. What you need, you know I got it. All I'm asking is for a little respect. Call me the King, let me call me just a little bit Mr. Custodian. I ain't trying to be
my respect as if I were, oh, I don't know, Rodney Dangerfield or Otis Redding. I mean, Vashti, you are banished. You and all your girls. And don't cry, because I'm not letting you back.
Oh, we're not going to cry. We're going to New Jersey, and we have news for you.
Yeah, and when we did the spiel in 2013, the Jersey Boys deal, that was great big news.
Pay attention. That was really great news. And how much of that do we get?
Boys are boy, oy, oy, Jersey boys. I right, they can't stop me, girl. Sure, our path was long and twisty. Had to get around Chris Christie. Big girl, don't cry, we don't cry. These girls don't cry.
It's just an alibi.
Big girls don't cry. Bye, King, bye, bye. Big girls don't cry. Bye, King, bye, bye.
Well, that sure explains a few things anyway. But boy, she sure could sell a song. You know, I'm just a little jealous that it's so much easier for her to sing falsetto. But anyway, you know, I need a new queen. Find me a new queen.
Okay, but what do you want in a new queen?
She should be young and sweet.
Okay.
Under 17.
That might be a problem.
All right, under 70. She should feel the beat.
Of the tambourine?
Yeah, and make sure that she can dance, and she can jive, and surf. And she should be a little bit country, a little bit rock and roll, maybe disco, maybe some folk. You know, I once tried to eat a piece of matzah, so no Jewish girls.
That is a tall order. I think we need to call in the Navy, the Rodgers and Hammerstein Navy. A king must have the finest to be found among the fair young maidens in the land. We'll look around, we'll hunt them down. Bring them here, and you can give the best your hands.
102 girls for you, we'll bring back before we're through. We'll get a load of honey buns tonight.
Okay.
We'll get one that's tall, one that's small, one that's curvy. Overall, there's gotta be one here that'll be right. We need somebody newish, a girl who isn't shrewish, with lips like hips and twirly hips, and isn't Jewish.
Don't know if this one's up to snuff, but let's make sure we have enough. You're a boy, don't run, 'cause you could be the one King's honey bun.
You've all been drafted.
Get your lipstick and your gown and come on down.
And make it snappy. This is your chance, sing and dance and win. Ah! Bravo! Yeah!
Okay, Mordecai, I've been drafted!
Another surge against the Babylonians!
This is a 2010 spiel. Aren't we out of Babylonia yet?
It's not the Babylonians, it's that replacing Vashti thing. The king's men have issued a summons to every female they could find who was...
younger than springtime? Pink and white like peaches and cream that enjoys being a girl?
Well, yeah, all those, plus me. I mean, I heard them say that I'm not really their type. They grabbed me to fill their quota, like 102 or some such number. Oy vey. Tomorrow the king's having a beauty pageant? Or possibly a hootenanny or a prom? I don't know. None of it sounds like a good idea. I wonder what they'd do to me if I went AWOL.
That could be dangerous. Look, don't worry. Just go. Maybe something good would happen.
Yeah, you know, Esther, the king could choose you to be queen.
But Cousin Mordecai, I'm just a simple Jewish country girl working on her MBA at Shushan Valley University.
concentrate on my career before I get married. All right, fine, an MBA, good, but what about your MRS?
Remember, I was always saying, don't be lonesome if you're staying in the library, you'll never be a bride. While you're getting your degree, get a bachelor who's a he. No one can fix you up, but Bobby tried.
One and only rebel child from a family meek and mild. Your Bubby seemed to know what lay in store.
Well, I liked all my schoolish learning towards the books I kept on turning till Bubby couldn't nudge me anymore. You turned 21 in college working on your MBA. Had no time to date, but Bubby tried, Bubby tried, Bubby tried to fix you up, but my friend's grandsons you denied.
No one could get you hitched, but Bobby tried. Your late daddy, rest his soul, left this with a heavy load, and that is how his family was built.
By the time I got this aged, thought at least you'd be engaged. Mother love just do it out of guilt.
She took 21 in college working on her MBA. She had no time to date, but Bubby tried, Bubby tried, Bubby tried to fix her up, but all those blind dates she denied.
No one could fix her next, but Bubby tried.
You know, Esther,
yeah?
If you win, you not only get a ring, but you could get me a job at Shushan Palace.
Yeah.
And don't forget about that crown.
But do I really need a crown to be happy? You could sell it on eBay. Pay off my student loan.
Oh, that would make me happy.
Esther, I have a fabulous feeling. In fact, it's kind of a Fab Four feeling.
That tomorrow is going to be...
Wait for it.
Esther Day. With your cup, I do not mean to drain. But your shirt is still King's heart away. Tomorrow will be Esther Day.
It's clear, though I feel like saying they is near. All I have to do is persevere. Oh, Esther Day is really here.
Yes, she is a true, this is true, but all is well. What king doesn't know, doesn't hurt.
Don't ask, don't tell.
Esther Day, King will see you and he'll shout, hooray. You will blow the other girls away.
Yes, tomorrow will be Esther Day. We believe in Esther.
I've asked some of your friends from Hill Valley to come give you a word of advice. Dan, we have to get back to the future, to the prom, to the beauty pageant, to the hootenanny, whatever.
Oh, you mean my friends Tina and Marge?
Kings advise to Shushan, the immigrants, yeah, that's for sure. Except
shiny. Is it time for the beauty pageant scene?
Yes, and it's Motown.
King, I think you need to put on a shirt and tie like Melina said. This is Motown.
Look, look, King. Look here. Here's the ballot. All you have to do is choose which one you want to vote for queen. And that'll work. Then we'll pick, you'll be able to pick your queen. And there are some of the most marvelous and supreme fair beauties in the land. And so here they come. Get ready. The most marvelous, the marvelettes, the supremes, and Esther.
Marvelettes, Supremes, and Vandellas, I just cannot choose you.
What? Why not?
Look, I can't stand wearing a jacket and tie, and so Motown is out. Esther has been dancing away over there at the end. And look, you may all be divas, but she's a 70s disco diva.
Friday night I should be at shul. Now I'm palace. Your golden scepter is fine. You are my new heartthrob. Can my cousin get a job?
Okay, my Persian queen, the young and sweet, sort of 17. Persian queen, feel the beat of the tambourine. Oh yeah. Esther is the winner, and the winner takes it all, the loser's standing small, beside the victory, that's her destiny.
Watch the hair. It's always a problem.
Now, I suppose winning includes giving your cousin a job in the palace coffee house?
Yeah, and would you hire my friends, Tina and Marge, to be my serving girls?
It is a done deed. Come, my dear, let me show you around the palace. And I trust, though you're a 70s dancing queen, you can still sing folk songs.
Yeah, and actually, I'm studying the banjo right now as we speak.
No wonder the whole palace sings your praises.
Marge, you know, I gotta be the happiest guy in the world right now.
Look at
me. Yeah, you know, Esther is queen of Persia, and the Jews are not being persecuted. And I got this great job at Shushan Palace where I can keep an eye on Esther.
How did you do that?
Oh, am I glad you asked. In the palace, you don't know this maybe, there is this peephole. And through this peephole, I can see what's going on inside the palace. And if Esther ever needs me, she can talk to me through this peephole.
Wow, you are lucky. Peephole. When you have a peephole, you're the luckiest peephole.
They do seem happy.
But maybe just counting their chickens before they hatch.
Bubby, who are they? Aren't they supposed to be on guard in the king's quarters?
They look familiar, but I don't know their names, Rue. Were they in primary debates?
Tarish!
Big fan.
I made a poison pellet in the vessel with the pestle. Then I put the poison pellet in the chalice from the palace.
Oh, Big fan, you're poisoning a castle of chassels?
Oh, no.
In the castle?
The king is the thing.
Oh, you're poisoning a pastel of vassals, chassels, and the chalice.
But I dropped the chalice, palace, chalice, and it fractured into fragments. So I put the poison pellet in the flagon with a dragon.
Flagon with a dragon. That's the famous dragon flagon.
Yes. Put the dragon flagon where king can see. He'll drink that stuff and sure enough he will die in agony. King Ahasuerus
loves that fancy cup. He'll drink that stuff, sure enough, and his time is up. Oh, put the bag and dragon where King can't see. He'll drink that stuff, and sure enough, he'll die in agony. Put the dragon flagon where King can see. He'll drink that stuff, and sure enough, he'll die in agony. Once he's nice and dead, we'll no longer be vexed. Noble kings and princes, all those guys will be next. Why are we so angry? Why are we so gruff? Don't you know we're eunuchs? So that is reason enough. So put the bag and dragon where King can see. He'll drink that stuff and sure enough he'll die in agony. Put the bag and flagon where King can see. He'll drink that stuff and sure enough he'll die in agony.
Assassins, now I must be brave. There's just one way to save the day, that I will be King's fave. I'll set Esther a latte and make it nice and hot. And in the foam, I'll write a poem about this deadly plot.
Once we have succeeded, we will have great fame. Everyone will lower the flag when we call out our name.
I hope she sends the guards, and that it won't take long. I don't know how much longer I can listen to this.
All right, one more time. Oh, flip the magic flag where King can see. He'll drink that stuff, and sure enough, he will die in agony.
Think you're big bad wolves, you merely huffed and puffed. The guards are here, feel free to cheer. The king will not get snuffed.
Thanks, guys. Now, let's not rile up the king with this, but be sure to let Esther know what's going on. And be sure to post it to the Palace Facebook page so I can link my blog to it.
Okay, but we really gotta go because everybody's gonna be worried about this security problem.
Bubby, a little bird told me that the princes are as mad as wet hens. Those 1968 party princes, they don't look worried. They look like they know that in another dimension, the stuff they're smoking backstage will be legal.
No. Not those princes. These are the 2009 Broadway princes, and they have 2009. They're brooding over 2009 worries.
Well, don't you think those problems ought to be solved by now?
What is it?
We have a national emergency.
Unemployment keeps rising.
Sick people keep thinking we should insure them.
Well, you mean we should do something about this?
No, we just need a vizier who can rule with an iron hand.
A vizier who could find somebody else besides us to blame.
Well, who do you suggest?
In a time of recession, we need some oppression to help us with homes that we have to foreclose. For all the Wall Street tanks, those of us running banks still deserve a big bonus, as everyone knows.
Health insurance companies must have a friend who's strong, one who won't cry when the claim we deny.
Don't want a friend who is phony. Our
don't apply. It's hard to choose when you're watching the news, but pick me, I'm your sleaziest guy. I am just a traditional villain with a traditional scowl in my eye. Think I won't gloat when a noose springs your throat, then I tell you, you've got the wrong guy. I'm mean and obscene, I hate everything green, look for somebody weak to abuse. And history shows us it's always a bonus whenever a villain hates Jews. I'm a villain, as can be imagined, all of my enemies happen to die. If you're with me, then I promise you'll be hand in glove, hand in glove.
Hand in glove, hand in glove.
Hand in glove with the sleaziest guy.
Well, I guess you do fit the online job description. What did you say your name was?
I didn't say.
So what is it?
Well, I can't say. I can say it, but there's a problem.
A problem? Hey, man.
Oh, that's it.
Heyman. Okay. I'll just call you Vizier.
Oh, thank you, King. But one thing I have to ask of you. In order for me to do my job right, you must decree that in my presence, everyone must bow.
So be it decreed, Haman. Okay, okay. Your first job is to stop that noise.
Oh. This is gonna be a walk on the beach, boys. Bow, 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 bow down to me.
Bow, 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 bow down to him.
Little lower, please, please. Left foot a little further back. Yes, 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 yes. Good, good, good. How about grumbling a bit more? Ah, Sal, that is good. Very good. You can all go now, except for you.
What's your name?
Mordecai. Why?
Well, listen, Mordecai. From now on, this is how it's going to happen in Vegas. My story's much too sad to be told, but nearly everything leaves me totally cold. The only exception is sometimes how, when I'm spending a quiet hour just amassing a bit more power, and I see how the riffraff cower. I love how they bow. I'm gonna start a campaign. Being vizier doesn't thrill my career unless everybody kowtows. I get a kick out of bounds.
You're a bit thick in the brain. It's not that I'm proud, it's that I'm not allowed. Yes, that is the case for any Jew. No bowing schtick, not for you.
I get a tick every time I see you standing upright before me. You're just a heck, but I must decree nobody gets to ignore me. I've got to pick a decree. Yeah!
That's how I get out of the tree. This is terrible. To imagine, 5 minutes ago I was the happiest man on earth, and now this. And it's all my fault. Not only do I have to face the music, but I have to face the Jews of Shushan. People, I've got some terrible news for you.
What is it?
The king's prime minister, Haman, issued a decree that since the Jews won't bow down to him, they shall all hang from his gallows.
Oh, boy!
Hey!
Hey!
No!
What we have here is a Tzoras line.
Right.
Yes, you must go to the king and tell him you're Jewish and save your people.
Right.
Wait a minute. The king doesn't know I'm Jewish. This does not seem like a good time to tell him.
But Esther, you can't abandon your people. Look into your heart and realize your fate lies with us.
My heart. Yes. Yes. I feel it beating a Broadway rhythm.
I do too.
Something from Bernstein and Sondheim, perhaps. Why, I feel Jewish, oh so Jewish. It's so true like a Jew's how I feel. So Hebrewish, think I'll star in someone's Purim spiel. I feel keenly that I'm queenly, since our monarch has made me his bride. 'Twould be so keenly if I stopped a bit of genocide.
La 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 la.
See that nasty Haman build gallows there.
Gallows where?
Just how evil can that man be?
Which, what, where, who?
Who can save the day? Who can show the way? Look, what can I say? There is only me.
I feel Jewish.
Oh, so Jewish. It is true that I feel like a Jew. For I know what it is that I have to do. Only one problem. If the king, if I go to him unsummoned, and he does not raise his golden scepter, I will be put to death.
Ooh. Then don't go. Don't go, Esther.
But I must. I must save my people.
Oh. Don't go. Please don't go.
Don't go. Don't go. Don't go. Don't go.
Don't cry for me, Magentina.
No, 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 no.
Oh my gosh. Come on, I got. Oh, no, look who's here. It's Bobby.
Belinda's.
Hey. Yeah, into the mic. Esther is hatching a plot to tell us her plan in an 80s power ballad, and you cannot sing in the 80s power ballad if you don't let go.
No, and the chicks, you know, you have to shake a tail feather now.
Ooh, an 80s power ballad.
Yeah.
As I understand it, this is how it goes.
Jews, lock on over here.
Let's try that again, shall we? All right, I'm ready. Haman wants to kill every Jew. Jews won't bow, that could be me too.
It's tough, so tough.
I go intercede with King A, but he hasn't called me, so I'm killed anyway.
I'm coming, I'm summoned.
King's got a whole bunch, that scepter he's got. Well, that's what makes the difference if I make it or not. He loves me, that helps a lot with love. The Jews have a shot. Whoa, we can't despair. Whoa, living on a prayer. Let's take hands, we'll make it, I swear. Whoa, living on a prayer. I'll invite the king to come down.
And if I perish, I perish.
Atta girl. You go.
Chin up. Yeah, but not too far. Just, you know, watch your neck.
So now Esther has to make a banquet for the king and Haman? How is that?
Now, what are we going to do?
There's only one thing we can do. Oh, we must wait a while. Oh, we must wait a while. Unto you. I know he doesn't sound like that, but that's what he said to me. Really? Well, what did you say?
Well, I asked Tem and Haman to a banquet.
You asked for a banquet?
Yeah. And that banquet went great, too. The king said,
once again, what is your petition? It shall be granted you. And what is your request? Unto half the kingdom. It shall be fulfilled.
Sounds good. So, what did you say?
Get ready. I asked him and Haman to another banquet.
Look, I said if I perish, I perish. But just one lousy last meal does not seem worth it, you know?
She always was a good eater.
It's the king. Does he look bloodthirsty or normally thirsty?
When I was a young man and too young to drink, about wine and beer was all I could think. I turned 21 and I got me some wine, but it tasted just like turpentine.
Ooh, tasted like turpentine.
I searched everywhere in Paris and Roma. I searched down in Napa, I searched in Sonoma, but all the world's wine, it just went to waste, 'cause I never much liked the taste. Banquet, she had some wine there. The color was purple, the bottle was square. I took my first sip, so sweet, so divine. She had Concord, Manischewitz, grape wine. Honor that rat, Mordecai. He just saved his life, so I had to comply. I drank Esther's wine, it went right into my head, and I, I fell on her bed.
Oh, and it fell on her bed.
Frankly, Haman. Homicidal sociopath, well, that's in the job description. But falling on Esther's bed, that is beyond the pale.
Hey, here's Esther!
What would you do if I said I'm a Jew? Would you stand up and walk out on me?
Say you're a Jew, I would only say no. That really means buckets to me.
Yeah, she got by with a little help from her friends.
Except her high with a little help from my friends.
Yo, I'm your guy with a little help from your friends.
Hey, man, it's true, that's the deal every Jew. Would you stand by and let him kill me?
Esther, my dear, you have nothing to fear. It's all over for Haman to see.
Yeah, she got by with a little help from her friends.
Got her high with a little help from my friends.
Yo, I'm your guy with a little help from your friends.
Do you need anybody?
I need somebody to love. Just need Esther to love. Haman, come here, tell me what is that there? Those are gallows for the Jew Mordecai. May he save my life and raise Esther my wife. Why don't you give those gallows a try?
Yes, she got by with a little help from her friends.
Oh, and finally, I got with a little help from her friends.
Shut her high with a little help from our friends.
She got by with a little help from her friend. With a little help from her friend.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. Well, there's just one tiny problem. Well, it's not so tight. The Jews of Persia are now free to defend themselves, but Haman's murderous forces are already on the way. The Jews must be warned. What year is it? Where am I? Why am I here? Who are these people? Why are they staring at me? Have cell phones been invented yet?
Dude, we're Jews. There's always a way to get the word out. Sound a warning now, night and day and morning now. Come on a safari with me. Grab your wife and children.
my camel if you don't have a car. Born in Jesus and Persia, that's what it's all about. We're heading out blowing shofar.
Come on, Hebrews, go shofarin. She and Hebrews, go shofarin. Don't be baby, go shofarin.
Like Joshua and Jericho. We don't have Mitchell yet, so this is how we want. There's no time for the status quo.
Come on, Hebrews, blow it, Jabari. She and Hebrews, blow it, Jabari. Hold on, baby, blow it, Jabari.
They're looking out for Haman and his terrible band. It's Sodom and Gomorrah, you can see it stands the border with your bugging across the land.
Come on, Hebrews, blow it, Jabari. She and Hebrews, blow it, Jabari.
Come on, baby,
blow it, Jabari.
Haman right here. You have taught me what it truly means to be a king. I now know that the king must really care for his people. Let's declare this a holiday for the people.
Yes! Yes.
This
This is the day that Esther saved her people.
Yay! A day for giving and a day for eating Hamantaschen.
From now on, I will be a real king. In fact, thank you very much. The king, hit it. It should not feel the temperature rising, It's the oven set at 350 degrees.
Audience, don't just sit there. Get out of your shells a little bit and crow. Turn your programs over and you'll find the words on the back.